The effect of the vaccines on the COVID-19 pandemic has been tremendous. We've seen some data coming out nationally that's showing us that in our portions of the population where we have greater than 80 and 90% vaccinated people, COVID is disappearing. The drop-off in what we're seeing in people who are hospitalized, who are seriously sick, who are showing up in the emergency room is directly opposite of what we see with vaccination. The more people get vaccinated, the fewer people in your community or in your age group that are getting seriously ill with COVID. We know that of the people who are currently being admitted to the hospitals and dying, 99%+ of them are unvaccinated. The vaccine has had a tremendous impact on being able to protect people from getting seriously ill with COVID-19. It's really important for all of us who work here at Arkansas Children's and all of us who are parents and adults out in the community to continue to get vaccinated so that as many of us are protected as possible. We know there's a lot of data now coming out to show that even if we're exposed as people who are vaccinated and get sick with COVID-19, we're not going to get as seriously ill, but most importantly, we don't shed nearly as much virus, so we are much less likely to get someone else sick. That makes it really important for us as parents, as community members, and as healthcare providers here in our system to do everything we can possibly do to protect the children we're entrusted with. And vaccination is the best step forward in that direction. The real-world data we're seeing regarding the effectiveness and the safety of vaccines has been really reassuring in the 8 months since the mRNA vaccines were introduced in the United States. What we've seen is a tremendous decrease in the number of people who are getting sick with COVID and people who are getting admitted to the hospital in those who are vaccinated. But we're also seeing some really reassuring effects in terms of safety data in populations that we initially didn't have a whole lot of data on, in terms of patients who have immune suppressed conditions or patients who are pregnant or want to become pregnant. We've now got data showing us lots of women have successfully gotten pregnant, had healthy babies, and even better, their healthy babies actually are born with antibodies to protect them from COVID-19 when they're getting vaccinated. So all of this data has been really reassuring for us in terms of the safety profile. Even the concerns that we've seen in terms of new monitoring of safety issues, because we are constantly watching new vaccines when they enter the market to make sure that they're safe and to make sure as we give them to more people, there aren't new things that show up. One of the things that we saw arise was a concern about heart inflammation in young boys when they got the vaccine. What we found now is that is much milder and much less common than the heart effects that we can see from COVID-19 itself. So even with that safety effect that we're all watching for and aware of, it's still much, much more beneficial for you to get vaccinated to avoid the serious heart conditions that come with post-inflammatory syndromes that we see with COVID-19. The COVID-19 variants are what we've seen where there are changes in the genetic code of the virus that show up over time. And this happens with all viruses as they start to circulate more and more in the community because it helps them to survive. They adapt to survive just like the rest of us do. And so what we've seen with these variants, these changes that show up, some of them are more easily spread than others, and that means they become the most common thing that we're seeing in our population. The way that we can stop the variants is by stopping the spread of COVID. So if we were all vaccinated and spread decreased, or if we were continuing to mask and stay distanced and spread decreased, then there's less of a chance for the virus to reproduce and for these changes or variants to be introduced into the population. The Delta variant is our newest variant of concern that we've identified and followed here in the United States. It originally arose in India, and what we have found so far is that it is much more contagious than any of the previous variants that we have seen. Some reports showing that it is as much as 80% more infective than what we've seen with other variants. What that means is that it's much more likely for people who are not vaccinated to get sick with this variant than they were with the original COVID strains and even our earlier variants. So for people who are eligible to be vaccinated but haven't elected to do so yet, they're much greater risk from the Delta variant than they were from the prior COVID-19 strains. Most importantly though, as a pediatrician and as a mother of a 10-year-old, children who are not eligible to be vaccinated are much more likely to get infected with this strain because it's more infective. So it's really important that we do everything we can do to get this strain out of circulation by vaccinating, distancing, and masking. It's really important for all of us who can get vaccinated to go ahead and do so to protect the people who can't, like those who have allergic reactions or those who have medical conditions that might make it harder for them to be vaccinated, or most importantly, our children under 12. They're relying on us to be able to get the virus out of circulation so that they can be protected. And every one of us can do that by getting vaccinated, continuing to wear our masks, and continuing to distance as much as possible.